You can never trust other people's demos. And even though I've seen some really cool ones, I want to do my own, but I want it to be a bit more raw and unedited. So I'm going to pull a fresh copy of OpenSaaS, which is a free open source SaaS template with 13,000 stars. I think it gives a good basis for the coding model to work on top of. I'm going to put it into Cursor, and I'm going to see what it can do with the starter template. I just pulled a fresh template, like I said, and I asked it for just the first start here to take the landing page in the code, which is here. So all the code in OpenSaaS is organized vertically. So I told it, look at the demo app, which is just like this simple, like AI-powered to-do list, right? You give it tasks, then it'll chunk those up and give them priorities for you. So I said, take that demo AI app, make that the basis of our new SaaS here, and update the landing page. But before I do it in plan mode, so I say, come up with three different design styles or pros and cons to help me choose which one. And it said, come up with this, you should use this interactive product-led demo. So I said, fine, go for it. And it built this on first try, which I think is pretty cool. Can I delete that? No. So it's like nothing insane, but I didn't edit what the created plan, and it came up with this nice interactive visual component, and it changed the landing page that we already have, added features to the bento box. So that's a pretty cool start, I would say. I would probably go from here and change stuff up, but that is quite impressive. Like I actually didn't have never had in mind a visual component like that. It's obviously not 100% in tune with how the actual thing looks, but whatever. I guess a good start. It's nothing like insane, but pretty cool. So let's try something else. Now I want to take a look at that demo app and the demo AI day scheduler. And I'm going to give it a little more complex task. So I'm going to say in plan mode, let's use structured outputs feature on the OpenAI API on the demo app page instead of the current function calling implementation. Let's see how it does with that. I mean, I'm already giving it to the plan, so we have a possibility to review and change it. Okay, so here's the plan. It says we will refactor generate schedule with GPT, which is the function, which is a server-side operation, server-side function, to use OpenAI's structured outputs. It involves defining a ZOD schema. So I'm not sure if that is the correct method to use. It's still in beta. But we'll switch to the model to 4.0 mini, replace tools and tool choice with response format, and use completions parse instead of create. So that sounds good to me. Based off what I know, I don't know it too deeply. Let's see what it can do. Okay, that was fast. So we've got a new ZOD response, ZOD object, the tasks with the tasks items, with their description and priority. Very cool. And let's see, we pass. So instead of passing tools, we now should have a output response, which uses the ZOD response format, which is an OpenAI helper, which they are importing, which is very cool. So right, by defining that ZOD object and then just passing that to the helper, we can get the structured output. And let's see, da da da. So keep. I want to keep all. Awesome. And let's see if that works. So we can go to the demo app and we say, let's enter some tasks. Learn Gemini 3 AI model for coding. refactor my SaaS app, film it all for a dope video. And I'll work 8 hours today. So generate schedule. Awesome. So it gave two tasks high priority, which is kind of dumb, but broke things up into subtasks with 20 minutes each. I mean, this is just a play around demo anyway, so it's like not really that important, but pretty cool. Also something that's not perfect, but definitely refinable. And that was a great way to refactor something that I haven't read the documentation on. So I would say, that looks pretty good. I must say that like none of it is like mind blowing yet at the moment. So let's give it an even more difficult task. So let me try this here and let me tell that all to Gemini 3 right now. Allow. I've never used this before, so this is the first time. Oh, nice. Let me stop that. Let me try again. I want to add new functionality to this demo AI app by adding a chat interface and allowing me to collaborate with the AI model's suggested daily plan before actually committing to a plan. So can you help me create this chat interface, add some functionality where we can review the plan together and accept a plan before we output that plan below the chat interface with the tasks and subtasks as it currently is in the demo AI app. All right, cool. Go back into plan mode. Okay, here's the plan. We'll separate the planning process into a collaborative chat session and a final commit action. So it's going to do some backend updates, define planner response schema, implement get agent response, accepts history, calls parse with planner response schema. So using that same structured outputs that we have before, and accepts a schedule. We're going to register new actions in the WASP config file. We're going to update with a planning chat component, user and AI chat history, handles the proposed plan. All right, I like the sound of that. Let's go ahead and go for it. Okay, so it finished. All I had to do was kind of instruct it to run npx shadcn to get the scroll area component in the right directory, and that was it. And it looks like we've got something up here. So we've already got the stuff from last time. The task from last time was start planning session. So there's a, you know, it's using shadcn components. So describe your preferences or just ask me to generate a plan. So I'm going to tell it I shouldn't spend too much time on learning Gemini. So let's make the video the top priority. All right, that looks nice. Just doing some thinking, taking quite a while. We're not streaming text probably, so this is what it's got. A structured your schedule to prioritize the filming video. So that's high, that's medium, low. Could you tell me more about the subtasks? Let's see what it says. I mean, that already looks really nice. Of course, we're using shadcn and it knows that, but the fact that it's embedded that into the chat window, I really like. okay, so not able to tell me out about the subtasks, whatever. We've got a great start here. I like it. Let's accept plan and boom, today's schedule is there. It is. So it probably has access to the subtasks, although it wasn't able to put them out. But I still really like the direction it went here. There are a lot of things I would change now. It's a bit cluttered, you know, things are popping up outside the different views and stuff like that, the different parent components, but I'd say that's a win. That's probably one of the coolest, one-shot features I've gotten from any of the coding models so far. Of course, lots of direction. There's a lot of foundation here, which Gemini and Cursor are using together to build with. But I mean, I think this is an insane combo, just from what I've seen now, using a SaaS template, whether it's this one, Open SaaS, or one that you can buy from any creator out there, or any other open source alternative, a solid code base that you know. And then get it to, plan and build features. This looks very promising. So I would have to say this is one of the few model announcements that I would say lives up to the hype. I like it. That's all, folks. Thanks for watching.